everybody. I hope you're having a great winter holiday season, wherever you are. I have had my eye on some slime kits and products from Slime Community for quite some time. This is my first purchase, and it took a bit because this company seems to sell out pretty quickly, which is awesome for them. I saw them on Instagram, I want to say. You know how when you like something, not even like it, but you just watch a video through once on any social media platform, that's what it keeps sending you? I think that's what happened. I checked out one slime video or clip, and then for the longest time, that's all I was getting. So, let's crack this one open. This beautiful pink box. And see what's inside. So this is the strawberry pie kit, and it looks like there's some directions for making the dough and chilling that for a little bit and adding the strawberry filling. So that's exciting. I see a slime egg. Oh my gosh. Oh, look at that. That is adorable. Sorry if that flashes you with some bright light. I apologize. Let's see. Some flower. A little rolling pin. Oh my goodness gracious. This is awesome. Jelly cube slime scented strawberry high chew candy. Oh my gosh. Oh my goodness. I think that's it. Ooh, you're having a cat. sugar and flour. Save half the flour for rolling out your dough. Combine well. Add just enough vanilla to achieve desired pie crust color. Refrigerate dough for 10 to 20 minutes. Nice. Okay, so let's set that off to the side. Oh my gosh, look at these. Oh, to go on top. Look at that. This is precious. Okay, vanilla. Probably just gonna say, oh my gosh, 25,000 times. Look at that. Look at that. Slime Community Farm Fresh Egg. So I do not have any experience with slime. It's not something I've ever purchased before. Oh my gosh, it's so sticky. This is all new to me. Look at that. That is awesome. The egg yolk is very... Oh my gosh. That is so cool. Look at that. Ooh, that's very solid. I don't know if it's supposed to be. This is so cool. Seriously. It's just gonna freak out. This is so cool. It's like all that messy stuff that if you're like me, you know, you weren't really allowed to do. I had to be clean all the time. Okay, we're gonna set that thing for a second. That is awesome. Oh my gosh. Pillowy. It's got like a little wetness to it almost. Not like you would think that would be wet, but it's just very, very sticky. This has kind of a wetness to it. And a cloud-like feeling. Oh my gosh, that is amazing. Look at that. Where has slime been all my life? So satisfying. My gosh. Thank you. idea how these two things are gonna mix together at all. Let's add some sugar. I might save some of this to add to some of the other slimes I bought. I don't know if that's how I'm supposed to do it or not, but that's probably what I'm going to do. Some flour. Seems very counterintuitive to do this. Like you're taking these things and like, is it gonna make it? I don't know. This little guy alone is just the greatest thing. So from what I can tell, slime community posts restocks on Saturdays. So you have to just maybe do what I did because I missed it a couple times and they were sold out very quickly when I would finally remember. I made a calendar reminder on my phone for like 10 minutes before. It was a cat ear. That's on me. That's not on the slime community. And when the before, it gave me enough time to find their page and get everything that I wanted. This is so much fun. I highly recommend this kit. Highly recommend it. This is real flour, potentially an allergen situation or not, but let me see if it's a... It didn't say. My guess is it's not, and it's some sort of powder that they use in making fluffier slimes, but I don't know. Look at that cool mix of yellow. Definitely helping with the stickiness of the egg. Okay, I think what I'm going to do is try to mix it out of the container now. I don't know if we're supposed to mix it in the container at all or not, but that's what I did. Okay. Thank you. stuff, like misophonia. I hate chewing sounds. Clicking sounds are really distracting. I have a little bit of touch stuff, like the baby yarn, the yarn for baby blankets and things. I hate that. So I wasn't really sure if I would enjoy slime, but it's awesome. I really, really like it. So therapeutic. I could see it really helping you have like the time blindness that comes with a really good craft project, where you're just so busy having a great time that you're not worried about sticky. I think we're going for a brown appearance. I mean, it is a pie crust after all. We're pretty far off from that so far. Still very much in the yellow zone. This will definitely have to chill. It's getting pretty sticky. This might sound weird, but there's a little alarm going off in my head, and this can tell you, you know, how I was raised by parents that wanted things neat and tidy. There's a little alarm going off in my head saying, like, oh, you're gonna make a mess. Oh, you better stop. You're gonna make a mess. This color is not going quickly and easily. Maybe we just won't make it that brown. And I hope that if things like that pop up in your head, even now as an adult, I hope that, you know, you power through like I'm trying to, and just make the mess. Make the mess. So what? There's nothing that can't be cleaned up. There's nothing we can't. If that's hard for you, like it is for me, get some slime. Make that inner child so happy. Let it rip. Let it rip. And I think one of the things that's helped me understand where those feelings come from, and why. See, freaking out. It's okay. Inside, I'm like, oh gosh, but you know what? You're helping me. I wanted to do this just for you, and so you're helping me, so thank you. One of the things I figured out from TikTok is how, if those are things my mom or dad said, not making a mess, worrying what someone else might think, being judgy, judgmental, TikTok has helped me understand that that's what happened to my parents from their parents, and it certainly has helped me not only forgive, but try to be more compassionate to them, and kind of help them become aware that those thoughts and feelings don't make them a bad person, and it doesn't mean that their parents were bad people either. It's just the source of it. And so if my mom was never allowed to make any mistakes, for better or worse, that's kind of what she taught me too. And when we talk about it, you know, that was certainly never what she meant or wanted. Having both of her parents now gone, my grandpa passed within the calendar year, and my grandma quite some time before that, I think that's almost been easier for her. Generationally, she had a very good relationship with her parents, but it wasn't based in a lot of verbal communication, a lot of acts of service. And so I think that some of the healing she's been doing is just mostly within herself, knowing that the tools for that communication were very hard for her and her parents. And so I think she is healing faster, just not even having to worry that maybe they wouldn't be understanding or reciprocate certain feelings in a conversation. It's, you know, it's disappointing that if she did have things she wanted to say, they're not physically present anymore. But spiritually, you know, whatever you believe, I know my mom believes that if she says something, that, you know, they could still hear her. And I think it took some of the pressure off. So, for me, I prefer that healing to be an actual conversation. I'm a total words of affirmation person. Also gifts, which... yay for me. Words of affirmation person, and so actual conversations are a big part of my healing. And I think it's pretty cool that given how conversations were not a part of my mom's youth, how she and my dad managed to create that space for me. I like to joke that my mom was a really good listener when I would get home from school and tell her about my problems, but that as I've gotten older, I realize some of that really great parenting was just, she was making dinner and I was rambling on and on and on, and I worked it out for myself, and then she was kind of relieved when I was done. Kind of like, yeah. Did you work it out for yourself yet? Okay, move on. Either way, it worked. It made me feel validated and at least somewhat understood, which is good. That's the funny thing about judgment and your inner critic and that inner voice that is so shaped by your parents is, my mom wasn't critical of me ever. Very supportive. Super high standards. But as the oldest child, I think I loved that. But she would make comments like, oh, look how bad their front yard looks. They haven't taken care of that. Or why did that person's haircut end up looking like that? Really? That's what they chose. Or that hair color. Boy. A big one was, oh, that hair color is so brassy. Why did she pick that? She needs to have that done. And you do, you internalize those things that, well, if I want to get mom's approval, or at least avoid disapproval, is that a word? I don't know. I can't make that mistake. You know, my guidebook to being okay is don't do that. As long as I don't do that, or that, or that, or that, I'm okay. She won't say those things about me. And so I hear myself think those things or say those same things, like, really? Those shoes with that outfit? Or, boy, you couldn't put a little mascara on today? Goodness, did you even try? And, it certainly doesn't stop those thoughts, but I guess at least I know where they're coming from, and story of when my sister was born. So I was born very premature, and I had to stay at the hospital for a long time. And when my sister was born, and she was jaundiced, and they wanted to keep her, my mom said, under no circumstances, what needs to happen so that I can take... Oh, awesome. See, that's what I'm doing. Instead of saying, oh no, I'm saying awesome. What needs to happen so I can take her home. And she had this, I call it a fish tank. It was like a little at-home incubator thing with the light system to help her liver. I don't really know the ins and outs of it, but when I saw it in a home video, I said I thought it was, you know, why are you putting her in a fish tank? To get her bilirubin up. And the next day, a visiting nurse had to come out and make sure that everything was okay. My mom was doing what she promised to do, and she wasn't just letting my sister sit there, you know, neglecting and not able to, you know, in too far over her head, not able to do what she promised the doctor she would do. And when she tells the story, one of her big, you know, the big punchline of the story is that it was very early in the morning that next day, and when the nurse showed up and knocked on the door, my mom was already in full hair and makeup. She was completely ready for the day already, first thing. And at that, the nurse said, oh, you're fine. And that's been the narrative of that high standard in our family ever since then. That my mom was, you know, deemed the gold star patient by this nurse for caring about her appearance, being an early riser, a go-getter. And I have made that my personality as well. Now, there are times, like today, today's the day after Christmas, where I knew what I wanted to do was have a couch day. Absolutely knew that. I didn't want to get up. I wanted to take a nap and watch TV, have my meals, and that was it. And there were so many times where I struggled with that I wasn't doing some of the work I knew I needed to do, and I kept having to tell myself, you do was. It was hard to relax, but I think my dad had an easier time in his life, kind of turning off that voice and just enjoying the relaxation and a little bit more self-nurturing time. And so I try to access that part of my personality and get a little stubborn with myself and say, no, you need this right now. You're taking care of yourself. You're not going to miss out on that for any reason. Anything that you need to do can get done tomorrow. It's very hard, though. Very hard. So there's that little part of me that can step away from some of those judgmental, internalized thoughts and do what makes me happy, but it's hard. I'm gonna try it a little bit. I don't know. Oh yeah. Oh, I'm too sticky. Well, there you go. Oh boy. No go. We're at a no go. Go no go. Chill out like that until this cools down. That's hilarious. Well, this is where we are, inner child, and that's okay. That's funny. Well, this is definitely turned pie crust color, and you definitely need the whole thing. The recipe said I only need half of this, so I'm guessing you can make two pies. There were two tins, so I'm going to let this set in the fridge for a little bit, and wash my hands, and come back and see you for the next part. For 10 minutes because I was being impatient. I only thought about putting this in for like the last 3 minutes, so it's a little better, but it's still pretty sticky, so we're working on it. Yeah, no big deal though, right? No big deal. Still, this is still sticky. Oh, it's still really sticky. Okay, so note to self, maybe put that flour on here, but that's okay. That's okay. We'll just use our hands. That's okay. It's just for fun. Just for fun. Trying to get some up on the edges to look like of the pie. Stick out. get, oh. How did you get up here? Okay. Clear jelly cube slime, scented strawberry high chew. Wow. It's so juicy smelling. Jelly slime. Look at this. So the jelly slime must be what the egg white was because it's kind of sticky. Look at that. The little cube. My gosh. It smells so good. So good. You have to smell that. One of the babies. Okay. Look at that. Look at that. My goodness sakes. Texture as the butter. What I'm going to do is leave this one as it is for now and hold on to it and then smush that one. They're sticking to me. Save it for next time. And we've had a rupture. Okay. Are you ready? It smells so good. never would have thought of putting salad non slime things in there. That's very cool. I really like it. Say it's cool. You've enjoyed this as much as I have. And that my silly little rant helped someone. I hope wherever you are safe and happy and healthy. And at least in the northern hemisphere, the days are going to start getting longer now. See you soon.